people think I am Mohammed. I'll hold it. I'll hold
just
it. It's much safer in my hands. It's safer if I am the one who gets hurt because the hole is in the Quran.
Let me
make my hair. Oh, I needed makeup today. I am out without makeup. That's just so bad.
Your mind, isn't it? Vagina and pussy and all that. That's all your head.
No? Is this the rat make the hole?
No, it's trying to fill it. It's trying to fill it. Go. Go up and go come. Are you Muslim?
Yes, I am.
I'm asking if someone can explain me why I have different Arabic Qurans.
Different Arabic Qurans?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
I am holding two different Arabic Qurans.
Yeah.
According to your Muslim scholars, that's the evidence that there are holes in the narrative.
There's only one Quran. There's only
why
one
I am
Quran.
Holding two different Arabic Qurans?
The fake. Is there only one Quran?
Which one is the fake?
I don't know, but there is only one Quran.
How can there be only one Quran if I am holding two?
No, it doesn't make any sense. There is only
I know,
one
it doesn't
Quran.
Make a sense. Because of that, your Muslim scholars said, okay, the standard narrative has holes in it.
Who is he?
Sheikh Yasir Qadir. You don't know him?
No, I have no idea
who he is. That's okay. We can put him under the bus, but in here I am holding two different Arabic Qurans.
No, I know only one Quran.
Where are
you from? All my life.
Where are
Lithuania.
You from?
I'm a converted
Lithuania.
Muslim.
So you are, okay. So which Quran in Lithuania do you recite? Do you recite half Quran? Do you recite the half Quran, or do you recite the Vosh Quran, or Kalun Quran, or Duri Quran? There
Arabic,
are 27 different.
They're all
different Arabic Qurans. So I'm asking, which Quran do you recite?
How many Quran do you know?
I have 37.
37. I know only one.
That's sad. I'm not Muslim, but I know 37. How come you know only one?
I don't know, but I know only
the Quran. The Quran you recite.
Have you got access
to internet?
Yes, of course.
Okay, go to the internet, and then tell me about the Quran you recite, for Surah 4, verse 43.
Can you tell her read for me some Quran?
Yeah,
Do you understand Arabic? No, you don't.
I understand the surah, I understand the prayer.
You can
pray.
That's not the Quran at all. Go Surah 4, verse 34. And then read it to me. 43. Surah 4, verse 43.
No, let him
to first read the Arabic for me, brother.
Yeah.
Can you?
I have the Arabic.
You phoned it,
yeah? Can you read it, sir? Can you read the Arabic for me?
No, I don't read
it. Okay, so you don't read it.
I'm learning.
Yes, you don't read it. Therefore, there is no need for me to read it. Can you tell me, if you recite this verse, how are you going to recite this verse?
So they don't speak Arabic, do they? I can read the translation, right?
Okay, read it.
What do you mean? You
talk about Quran.
You can read it.
Can you read some verse?
They're asking you, can you read Arabic? Alhamdulillah,
Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Malik. And then it goes on.
Can you read Quran? See, she doesn't even understand Arabic. How could she understand?
Do you read Quran? Do you read Quran?
Have you read the
Quran? Yeah, I read it. If I read something like this, I go and double check with people who can speak Arabic. Who can read in Arabic? Can you read in Arabic?
So I'm going to show you something.
How do you know they're not going to sugarcoat it for you?
I'm going to show you something.
How do you know they're telling the truth? They're not sugarcoating for you.
Are you serious?
Brother,
I'm serious.
Can you find the Muslim master?
I don't go to Imam. I can ask my friends.
How do you know they're saying
what's your name? Sir, what's your name?
Daniel.
I want you to look at this Arabic word. Brother, can you show that from that your Quran? Namastun. Okay, that's that one.
This one here.
Can you?
This one.
Okay. Can you tell me?
This one.
So look, this letter, okay, this word
and this word identical.
They are different. Look at it again.
One of them is
extra letter here.
Yep.
Okay? Elif. Extra A. Can you see this extra A?
Yep.
This small kind of postage thing,
like,
A.
Like
okay? So this one doesn't have that extra A. Okay. Do you know what is the implication of that?
No,
I don't know. Can you tell me if you can guess which word is that in that sentence?
It's
calligraphy, different calligraphy.
Is khat, yeah.
Is the same one that you are showing?
Half can it be the same? Half, so this is there are two Qurans, okay? The, one of them is on the phone. Mm-hmm. This one is here. This one, this one on the phone has extra letter.
Extra letter.
Okay, this one doesn't have extra letter. Okay. You can see that. Okay.
Okay. Okay. So,
when you translate it, even ask your Arabic friends, take the picture of it, and then ask your Arabic friends. When you translate it, it talks about you wash yourself, okay? Let me ask you basics. When you have sex with someone, okay? Do you do wudu or do you do ghusl before your prayer?
You need to wash yourself after intercourse.
So you do ghusl.
Yes, yes.
You have full bath. You have full bath.
You have to have full washing.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, of course. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So, if you just handshake with a sister, what do you do before your prayer? Handshake.
Yeah.
If you do handshake with a sister,
I don't.
You don't have to do bath. Okay.
Yeah. Yes,
so that just one letter changed the implication. If you need to do ghusl or if you need to wudu after you touch the woman. Okay. That just one letter makes it from touching sexually to just handshake touching. Okay? So it changed the implication of your daily life. So therefore, I'm sorry that you become a Muslim, but no one told you about 37 different Arabic Qurans. I think that is sad reality. Yeah, I think that's sad reality. Did anyone told you that Quran has been perfectly preserved?
It is perfectly preserved, yeah.
He just said
how can it is perfectly preserved if I just showed you two different Qurans?
No, you know, I didn't know about this, before today. But, I didn't know, so yeah. I will double check with everything, of course.
Okay.
I'm having a discussion with you.
So, let me ask you another basic question. When you go to your friend's house, okay, let's say he's not at home, but his wife is at home, and you need to wait your friend to come in, okay? Does your, if that Muslim friend, I don't know what is the percentage of Muslims in Lithuania, do you?
I live here. So.
Okay, you live in Britain. Yeah. So when you go to your Muslim friend's house and husband is not at home, it's only the wife, okay? You are waiting for the husband to come. Do you suck the breast of woman 5 times or you just don't do it?
I would never ever go to my friend's wife without his permission. Yeah, without calling him and asking him if I can go home, if I can get inside his house.
Okay.
Yeah, out of respect.
So, okay, let's say your friend said, I'm not at home. Let's say he said, I'm not at home. Mm-hmm. Go and wait for me. I'm going to be home in 5 minutes.
Yep.
Okay?
Yeah.
So, you went inside. Okay, your friend is not there. Would you suck your friend's wife's breast 5 times until your friend comes on so that you can sit with the wife?
No, I would wait for him.
So when you, so as you wait for him, would you suck the breast of the wife?
No.
No? Why?
No. Out of respect. I wouldn't do
so
that.
So out of respect you wouldn't suck the breast of your friend's wife?
No.
Okay. According to Islamic tradition, okay, Sahih Muslim has 4 pages on it, and Muwatta. It is talking about when you go to visit someone, okay? This woman had this man, young man who had a beard, needed to suck the breast of woman. It was first 10 times, but Allah abrogated it to 5 times. So man has to suck her breast so that they can be like brothers and sisters.
I don't know where she gained that from.
This everything was new for me. I will double check with my non-Muslim friends.
If it is true,
with just people who know how to speak Arabic.
So this is something happened at the time of Muhammad. Okay.
Okay.
And it is revealed from Allah as the word of Allah. Okay. So in today's Quran, did you read that story?
No.
No, you haven't read that story. You haven't read the story because sheep comes and then eat those verses, and those verses didn't make into the Quran.
I came to Islam because that's rational and logical. Just a moment. Yeah.
Those verses are not in the Quran. And you were told Quran has been perfectly preserved, and you told me that Quran has been perfectly preserved. If the verses are not there, and if I am holding 2 different Arabic Qurans, therefore they show me that Quran has not been perfectly preserved. If you find that out, what I'm saying to you is truth, what will you do? Will you give up Islam?
If I will find that this is
if you find out that there are different Arabic Qurans, if you find out that the Quran you are reading is not the same Quran which Muhammad received, will you give up Islam?
I need to double check first and then make my decision.
No, that is, if I am correct,
right now,
if I am correct, the question is if, okay?
Yeah.
If I am correct, that means you've been told lie, which you give up Islam. If you are correct, come to Speaker's Corner and confront me. I am here every Sunday, okay?
All right.
So, but if I am correct, will you give up Islam for the lies you've been told?
I will need to think about it.
Okay,
I
you need to think about
right
okay.
Now.
So, also you express that you become a Muslim because it was logical.
Yes.
Okay? Can you tell me the logic of, have you been to Hajj yet?
No, yet.
How long have you been Muslim?
Not yet.
How long
have
you?
6 years.
6 years. Can you tell me the logic of having kiss with the black stone?
Kiss with the black stone.
Yeah. What is the logic of the kissing the black stone? You told me Islam is logical.
I don't have enough knowledge about Hajj and Umrah to have a
what
conversation.
I'm not asking. Give me the philosophy of it. I'm asking. What is the logic?
I see it. I see it as the ritual.
So
you are quite
okay to go and kiss the black stone.
I don't see anything bad in it. If there is a story behind why people should do that and why is
So it was a white stone from paradise, entered the world because of the sins of Adam. Sins of people made it black. So you are kissing something which symbolizes the sin. Okay, as you kiss it, okay, black stone is going to intercede for you on the day of judgment and erase your sins. Would you find a problem with that? You wouldn't find a problem. So, I thought according to Islam, sharing the attributes of Allah with something was a shirk.
Yes, I know that. Yeah.
So,
yeah.
If the black stone
not,
is going
I'm not
to,
worshiping
if
this the, stone.
If the your intention to kiss the black stone, to your sins to be erased, and black stone is going to intercede for you, that's sharing the attributes of Allah with a stone.
What is your point then? I can kiss anything I want. Is that your problem?
Kiss anything you want.
Yeah,
I am asking
problem?
The question. The thing you are kissing,
so?
The symbol of the sin,
so?
And going to intercede for you, and going to erase your sins. That's the attributes of Allah given to the black stone that is called capital letter shirk.
Allah forgives the sins.
So when the hadith, when the Tirmidhi talks about in Tirmidhi 959 is Muhammad lying when he says it's gonna erase your sins.
Yeah, that's the means. So kissing the stone is the means.
No, it says stone is gonna have the lips and then going to remember this gentleman, Daniel kissed it. And I'm going to intercede for him, and because of that kiss, his sins are being forgiven. So that is shirk.
You believe the walls will testify.
I know. That's all. Like walls are going, trees are going to have consciousness. Trees are going to remember everything.
They are.
How can a black stone? What kind of miracle is that? I look at it and then I say it's a shirk. For black stone to remember. Who kissed it, okay? Let's practice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 people here, minimum 10 people, okay? For Blackstone to remember, every day 10 people kissed it, which is like joining the Hajj, millions of people. Blackstone must be all-knowing, all-powerful. It has to remember all day and then have perfect consciousness, very, very good consciousness.
Say, and Blackstone is all-knowing and show him, stay away now, show him. Why are you lying? Show him. Show him. You said you made
it. Is Muhammad a liar?
She said Blackstone is like when we worship.
What kind of attributes?
From the Quran.
What kind of attributes Blackstone must have to
worship,
erase your sins?
Yes.
Blackstone must know what were your sins. Blackstone must know what are the sins you are going to do in the future so that it's going to forgive your sins.
Ask her for proofs, mate.
Does that mean the stone is all knowledgeable?
That's what I'm asking you. You are giving that.
If the stone has knowledge, it doesn't refer to all knowledgeable.
What kind of knowledge Blackstone must have to remember since 1970 to 2020 how many people kissed it, what were their sins? And
is
then
it
it's
true
forgiven.
Or not that he says at the end the black stone gonna have a mouth
and
mouth,
tongue
and tongue and they're and gonna well, talk and they're gonna think. Is it true or not that the Omar
I'm
sorry,
it was
my sorry.
Say no, I agree with everything.
That's
what they're gonna do.
Isn't it true that Omar says, I know you are just a stone and I'm doing it because
Muhammad did so.
Is it true or not?
You have in the Bible, yeah. It says that the stone,
I'm not talking about I am not talking about the Bible. As a Christian, as a Christian, I'm not going to kiss in the stone so that stone forgive my sin. So you do that as a Muslim because you are I'm not talking about Bible. Can you be gentleman and defend the Islam right now? Actually it was you. Actually it was you. So you said Islam is like rational religion, logical. Yeah. So give me the rationality of passing black stone to erase your sins. How does black stone knows what you've done?
Where they say black stone?
We are not worshiping.
You are kissing
stone.
It. Why are you kissing it?
Tell us. Ask her for proof.
Why are you kissing it? Why are you kissing it? Why are you kissing it?
I don't have enough knowledge about this.
So you don't have enough knowledge.
Yes,
so you are kissing.
About
you are. Okay.
I don't have enough knowledge about.
But you have been Muslim for 6 years and you can't even give me the basic questions on tawhid. Don't you find that's a bit strange?
I haven't performed Umrah or Hajj yet.
But I'm asking questions about tawhid.
Yes.
So oneness of Allah, attributes of Allah is on a black stone, a stone. Black stone is all knowing, all powerful. Erases your sins. I gave the reference.
أعلم أنك لا تنفع ولا تضر. I know you don't do nothing. You don't harm. You don't harm. You don't do nothing. The black stone.
Okay,
but if I didn't see Prophet Muhammad kiss you, I would never kiss you. That Umar bin Khattab what he said. Should ask
the reference.
Well, yeah.
The reference.
Should ask what they say. I worship black stone. Sorry. Now they say it's not worshiping. Now they're changing the song. You said it's worshiping.
But erasing the sins of the believers.
You said.
So we are
Muslims worship black
stones.
Tell her to show you proof. That's it. Otherwise, don't talk to her. She's a liar. Be a liar.
That's the point.
And that one. And that man is deceiver. He looks nice,
that's the point.
But he's not. He's gonna put really bad titles on videos and stuff. Be careful. Just walk away.
This is my first time here.
Yeah, just
this is my first time here.
You are you Sunni Muslim? Are you Sunni Muslim?
Sunni, yeah. Sunni.
Have you heard Tirmidhi Hadith?
Yes. Yeah, of course.
Yes, you heard. Okay. So, can you tell me what it says?
This one is not the one.
Oh, sorry. 961.
Okay.
Sorry, I thought you find it. Sorry. 961.
961.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure, and then show this guy as well because he wants to know as well.
Okay, I read it. Okay. References. Tirmidhi 959. Tirmidhi 961. Sunna El Nasai 2919. Okay. Muhammad says, okay, the messenger of Allah said about the black stone, by Allah, Allah will raise it on the day of resurrection with two eyes by which it sees and the tongue that speaks with it, testifies whoever kissed it. Okay? Nasai 2919.
What?
Touching the black stone is going to erase your sins.
What? Touching what?
The black stone will erase your sins.
Is he worshipping? Is she worshipping? So you said it's worshipping?
No.
If it's going to erase your sins.
So why
if
you said
it is not going to erase your sins.
Why are you coming on my
argument? Our argument is that the
something is erasing your sins.
No.
It is worshipping.
No.
You are sharing the attributes of Allah.
So you have to prove it.
You are sharing the attributes of Allah with something. Okay, that's sure. Allah is Allah not only forgiving one? Forgiven?
Of course.
So, why is black stone erasing your sin?
It doesn't say that.
to us. I just read it to you. I read it to you. I read it to you.
But it's not worshiping. It's not.
So if the reason you are kissing, the reason you are kissing, your sins are gonna be erased. That's the reason you are kissing. It's not from heaven. It's it is a sign of sin. It's the symbol of the sin. And you are kissing it. It is your son doesn't forgive your sin.
Doesn't take away your sins, uncle. That's the whole
you
point.
You are kissing
is being questioned
through French kiss or whatever that kiss is, your sins are being forgiven from that one lip action. Voilà. That is
you say open books.
So when you do abolition, your sins are forgiven as well.
See who, from where? Could be Wikipedia.
Give me the reference.
Did you read it? Did you say we worship black
souls? So even the abolition forgives your sin.
Stop straw manning.
She
never said that.
She never said that? She didn't say we worship black souls?
She didn't say that. She didn't say that. Okay.
So here he says, a Muslim man does not perform ablution in an excellent manner.
That's not my question. What is the reference?
So him talk.
Abolition? You said abolition is going to abolition forgives your sin.
This is Sahih Hadith.
He showed you.
What is the reference?
It says Sahih Bukhari 158.
Sahih Bukhari.
Ablution forgives sins.
Okay. Abolition forgives sin. Can someone help me to understand how can water forgive your sin?
Because Allah has made
how can
means,
a water doesn't have a consciousness Allah, knows what you've done and forgives your sin?
Wudu has made it as Allah has made wudu as a means for the forgiveness of sins. So prayer.
Wudu is forgiving sajda, your sins. Sajda is forgiving your sins.
Yep. Forgiveness of your sins when you do make
when
wudu.
You do good things,
God
good
takes
deeds.
Sins from you. Not water.
And
God.
You bought that. And you bought that. Water is gonna forgive your sins.
It's a means of forgiveness.
Water is gonna forgive the sins of Muslims. And the water, and it is the water where they put it. The water, where they put it on their nose, the water they put wash their ears, the water they wash their feet before the prayer is gonna forgive their sins.
No water forgive us. God, when you do water, God forgive you for doing that. Yeah, read it. Is it say no?
Abolition. It says abolition. It doesn't say Allah. It says abolition.
Okay.
When you clean your nose, get rid of the Satan. When you clean your ear, get rid of the urine of Satan from your ear. When you clean your feet, that water has power to forgive your sins. Wonderful. Double shirk.
That's why
I can't remember how I missed this. I'm not talking about Bible. I am not talking about Bible. I am questioning the reason you become a Muslim.
I'm not agreeing.
You are not agreeing with what?
It's not a shirk.
It's not a shirk. What is shirk?
Look.
It doesn't say God. He read it. You are Muslim. Don't touch me.
Sorry.
Your Muslim brother read it. It didn't say Allah is going to forgive your sins. In the hadith I read it, it doesn't say Allah is forgiving your sins. It is the action of the kiss is making your sins to be erased by black stone. I read the hadith to you.
Read this one. You read Arabic? Read this one.
Islam doesn't make any sense.
That is
Islam
question being asked.
Islam doesn't make any sense. But you choose to follow Islam.
No, it doesn't make any sense.
I know, Islam doesn't make any sense.
Is it Bukhari?
No, I'm talking about shirk that you're blaming.
Which
that.
Book is it?
It is shirk.
Is it what? Listen.
It's shirk.
It's not
shirk.
It's your opinion. No.
Muhammad's opinion. I am not Muhammad. If Muslims are denying Muhammad today by going against Surah 465, I can't do much about it. You are already apostate. Just beware, there is a death penalty for apostasy.
You're trying to tell me that performing wudu is a shirk.
He told you. If that water is forgiving your sins, that's shirk.
It's not water forgiving your sins.
Who is forgiving your sins?
God forgiving the sins.
Did the hadith say God? No.
It says when you do abolition.
Abolition.
Do
it's abolition, the abolition. So how do you do abolition?
But it's not abolition.
How do you do abolition?
Yeah.
No, it doesn't say Allah forgives. That's your brother brought it up. According to your brother, that dirty water, which you get rid of the urine of Satan from your ears, the dirty water which you kick out the Satan from your nose, the dirty water which like you clean your hands,
It's not
that's
water.
Gonna,
it's God who forgive. Not
it
water,
doesn't.
Right?
It doesn't say God.
You would never, never.
It doesn't say God.
A million years.
It doesn't. I want you to tell me this verse.
What about the clean water?
Muslim 1430.
What about the clean water? You don't need to.
Sorry,
no, I understood.
Sorry, Allah doesn't speak English, brother. And his Arabic is very bad.
Jesus, which language he speak? Jesus, which language he speak? Your God. Which language he speak? Your God. Jesus.
Why do you kiss the black stone? Why do you commit shirk?
Jesus, which language
he
speak?
Why do you commit shirk?
I don't see that as shirk, honestly. I'm not that much knowledgeable about Islam and these things, but for me it's not a shirk.
So if the giving the attributes of Allah to something is shirk by definition, okay? Allah is the all-forgiving one. Allah is the all-knowing one, okay? Allah is the one knows what did you sin yesterday. Allah is the one who knows when you lied, okay?
Lying
is sin. Raping someone is sin. So let me finish, sir. Let me finish. You can't even defend your Islam. Be man for your Islam. Is it so difficult to be man? Is it so difficult to stand up for Islam? No, it doesn't look like you are standing here, but you are not standing for your prophet.
I'm answering.
Blackstone forgive your sins, okay? Blackstone needs to know what you sin. Okay? For Blackstone to know, not only you, but for everyone who went to Hajj and sinned, for it to remember what kind of attributes Blackstone must have. You help me out.
Nothing. So absolutely nothing.
For Blackstone to remember, thousand people sin and know what their sin was.
Nothing else.
And need to remember that on the day of judgment, what kind of attributes Blackstone must have.
How does it know your sin?
Absolutely nothing.
How
does it know your nothing. Sin? No, nothing. No attributes.
Brother.
How does it know your
brother,
sin?
Brother. Yeah. How does it know? How does it know? How does it know your sin? Brother.
Hello.
What kind of attributes you need to have to know what this guy did yesterday? What this guy did 5 years ago? What this guy did 5 years ago?
I need amazing knowledge.
So you need to have amazing knowledge. What kind of attributes you must have, you need to have to know what 1.6 billion of people did?
Knowledge of God, I would say.
So knowledge of God. What kind of attributes you must have to not only know what they have done, but what was their sin and have power to erase that?
Only God can forgive sins.
Only God can do. Okay, you must be God then.
I don't have God's knowledge.
Yeah, so that, yeah.
Sins.
If something is able to do that, something is able to have the attributes of God and practice that, that goes
and the slow Blackstone doesn't forgive sins. God he forgives sins.
It doesn't
Hatun,
say
why you
that.
Lying?
Had it doesn't
why you
say
lying?
That.
Why are you lying?
Muhammad was lying.
You're
I read the hadith to
you're
you.
Liar.
I read
you're
the hadith. Muhammad is a liar. Muhammad is a
don't
liar.
Lie. Look, he asked you a question. Jesus,
Muhammad
which language
is a liar.
You speak? Jesus, which
Muhammad
language
is
you speak?
A liar.
Ask her, which language you speak, Jesus?
Why are you asking that?
Because
you don't even know why you are asking that question. Why we are not even talking about the languages?
Yeah, so you said God. He speaks Arabic. You said Islamic God speaks Arabic.
So what is the language of the Quran?
You're saying
Arabic.
What is the language of the Quran?
You're saying Jesus is God, so you're saying he spoke Aramaic. So
no,
is that something negative?
God speaks all language. My God is not
Jesus,
limited to Arabic.
What language he speak? Tell us.
My God
what language he speak?
Is not
prove
limited
prove
to
prove
one language.
Which language he speak?
God
Aramaic or Hebrew or Greek? Tell us.
Aramaic, Hebrew, and Greek.
Show us.
Matthew chapter 15.
Open and
John
see.
Chapter 4.
Who
John
said
chapter
that?
4.
Let's say in about
and
him. Let's say in about
John
him.
John
chapter 10. I speak those languages.
Okay, that's your answer. Okay, cool.
So, now, bottom line is this. What's happening?
Look,
let me just identify. This Muslim man who has been Muslim for 6 years.
Are you jealous?
I am so jealous.
Are you jealous? Don't be jealous.
I am
look
so
how good
jealous.
He is. But I think he's married. I think he's not gonna, he doesn't fancy you at all. You know his type at all. Look how good looking he is. What do you want?
What are the things you looked into Islam, sir? What are the things you looked into Islam?
No,
everything.
How does it look to you?
Okay, basic.
One God.
Okay. Okay. So can you turn with me?
That's why he turns.
Surah 2, 223.
You want me to find the surah?
Yeah, I want you to explain that surah to me.
Tell us, tell us.
I want you to read it and then explain that.
I do it for you.
And then also, can you tell me if you kind of looked into the basics, what was your basic response for your prophet to have sex with a child? And also,
who said it's a child? In America, you're not allowed, a woman, she's not allowed to marry in age of 16. If you do that, it's rape. In England, you're allowed. Who we should follow? America or England? In Nigeria, girls are allowed to marry to age of 14. Who asked to say it's wrong? We can't say it's wrong. It's the culture.
So in what countries?
In Nigeria, girls are married at age of 14.
They're married at age of 14.
Who are you to say it's wrong? Who are you? Just because you are a white man, you say it's wrong? It's wrong? Your king, King Henry, he married a girl of age of 6 years old. King Henry did not have sex with a girl.
What is your basic answer?
Even Aisha in the fucking hadith, she said she cried when the Prophet died. If she thinks he raped her, how come? She grew up. If you grow up and the boy who abuse you, he's not here. You should say bad thing about him, innit? She was crying. It was the worst day in her life when Prophet he died.
Sir,
where is your God? Ask her. Did your God die?
What is your answer to the basic question?
I hope you understood. I came here not to argue. I came here to hear your point. Sir, hear your arguments against Islam.
You are Muslim. I'm asking the basic question.
It's the first time for me.
That's absolutely
here,
fine.
And I'm just listening to your negative point of view.
Because it is your first time.
Yep.
I'm being very kind on you, and I haven't butchered you on the target yet. Okay.
So I am asking,
as when you become a Muslim, okay, and you've been Muslim for 6 years, okay. How do you justify as a Muslim Muhammad's marriage when in his 50s with a child who was only 9 years old when he had a sex with her?
Who said that? Tell her.
Yeah. So you don't know that.
Just tell her.
You didn't know that.
Yeah.
Sir, you didn't know that before. You've been Muslim for 6 years.
Yeah, he married her in age.
Okay, so how do you justify that?
Well, how old she was when he married her?
Is that okay? Is that a good example for you?
Yeah, 1,400 years ago, a girl when she was 9, she's a woman, not like now. In that time, there is no nursery. There's no TV, there's no games. A woman, she's a woman, or kids. There's no like... teenager, do you got me?
But he's right. He's right somehow because before it was completely different.
Yeah, so before there's no nursery.
It wasn't like
there's a woman or kids. There's no teenager time.
Explain it to me, please.
But that was the
difference. What is the thing you cannot compare? Explain it to me.
Explain it to me.
Sir, I'm not talking to you.
I talk.
I'm not talking to you. Can you please explain it to me?
1,400 years ago,
can you please explain
it? A woman, age of 12, she's a woman.
Explain it to me.
I cannot compare this.
Okay, what was the different? What was different when she was 9?
She's a woman.
Okay? She didn't.
Now you're seeing from this point.
Listen to me. Yeah. Would you today, how old are you?
24.
As 24 years old man, would you fonder a child who is 6 years old?
No. Of course not. Of course
6 years old?
As 20...
Did Muhammad marry Aisha when she was 6? Why are you lying? Shall we go? We right?
So,
she said six. In a hadith, she said six. Ask her to prove she said six.
Would you have sex with someone while you are 24?
How old?
Who is 9 years old?
No, of course not.
Of course not. Okay, why?
Where is the verse?
Why?
Where is the hadith?
Just a moment. Why?
Hadith, she said hadith.
Why?
No. I'm saying, can you prove?
Why?
Shulim.
Sir, I know you treat him as an animal, but let him speak us corner to be human. I apologize.
He knows more.
You are Muslim. Okay. I'm asking. On the day of judgment, he's not going to be next to you. I'm asking you. Okay?
I'm not enough knowledgeable about
what kind of knowledge do you need to have to tell me what is the reason, what is wrong with having sex with 9 years old child? Do you need to be Einstein to tell me that?
Muslim. No, you cannot talk about this. Before it was different.
Sir. Child who just had her period, okay? First day of her period.
9 years old.
Yeah, he had full
nine,
sex when she was 9 years old.
Nine? Why are you saying six? It's nine. Why are you saying six? Why are you lied? Why are you lied to the man? She said six or no?
No, she did
she
not
said
say
six.
She said six.
So it's nine. Six. He's saying nine here. Why is she lied?
She did not say she had sex.
I said,
why is the merit? Why is the merit? Why is the merit?
I said, Fonda.
In Jamaica and Nigeria, women, age of 14, she got married.
I
who are you to say wrong?
That your Muslims thinks you've got no brain. I'm
from
really
Nigeria?
Sorry
no,
for
no,
that.
He's helping.
No, he's not helping. He's not helping you. He's not helping you. I'm asking you very basic questions, okay?
What I told you,
what kind of knowledge? Okay, tell me. Tell me. What kind of timeline is it ever okay for you to put your private part on a child who just had her period?
We just said. No. We just said. In that time, 9 years old woman, she's a woman because in that time, there is no nursery, there is no teenagers. In that time, rather you woman or kids. Do you got me? When you women or kids.
For me, it makes sense.
Teenagers, teenagers, they make it here.
I want you to explain it to me. This guy is screaming, I'm not listening.
Tell her.
Please be the Gabriel and then bring this message to me.
Married in England. It's 15, 16, by if your father allowed you. But in America, it's wrong. So what will you follow?
Even medicine, even the hospitals. Do we have...
Sir, is it hospital, the same? Is hospital,
the same?
No, but I'm hospital is not your best example. Mohammed is your best example.
Would you, as
24 years old, man who lived in 7th century, had a sex with a child, have a sex with a child who just had her period?
In 2020, of course, no.
In 7th century?
I don't know. How can
you
I
don't
how
know.
Can I tell
he doesn't
you?
Die.
How can
you
I
don't
tell
know.
You?
It was never
die. I didn't live
ever.
At that time.
Friend,
I didn't
die.
Exist.
Now
I didn't exist at that time.
Why a man of God comes and don't correct the wrong tradition? That is my question.
Turn with me, Surah 65 verse 4.
How come tradition came here?
No. Turn with me to Surah 65 verse 4.
Be of logic.
Surah 65 verse 4. Open Surah 65 verse 4.
I will find it for you.
Let me make my point. Is there?
Your prophet, who's supposed to be the best example for all times, thought it was all right when he was in his 50s, okay, probably like twice of his age.
No, I'm 45.
Went on the top of a child and had a sex with a child. She just had her period, okay? She just had her period. Surah 65 verse 4 talks about you can divorce the ones who are yet to have.
What he's showing you, read it. What he's showing you now? You go against them. Read it. You don't go against them.
Can I see?
You go against them.
One of the things happens is...
He go against them.
Muslim converted this guy 6 years ago. And new Muslim apparently been treated by long-term Muslims just as like no one who knows
so
nothing
about Islam.
He doesn't know the Tawhid. He doesn't know what Muhammad did to Aisha. He doesn't even know the basics.
What's wrong with this? Tell us what's wrong.
Would you divorce someone who is yet to have her period?
What?
What could you repeat?
Would you divorce someone who is yet to have her period?
No.
No, why not?
No.
Why not?
What does it say?
Just a moment.
It's not the Islamic approach.
It's not the Islamic approach. Would you marry with someone who is yet to have her period?
No. In 2020, no.
20,
no.
Okay.
No.
So I have here Quran. Can we please rip out Surah 65 verse 4?
I got it.
No, we want to delete that out.
So tell her.
He thinks this verse is not for us.
Ask her.
If you think as a 6 years old Muslim man, you've been Muslim for 6 years, if you think it is wrong for you to marry someone who is yet to have her period, if you think it is wrong for you to divorce someone who is yet to have her period, you are disagreeing with Allah in Surah 65 verse 4.
Can you prove me?
You just read the verse.
No, ask for proof.
You did not read the verse. It says yet to reach her period.
In the translation.
What is when they are yet to menstruate?
Young girl.
What kind of people are not menstruated yet? With 65 years old woman had her period.
In that time. Now.
That's now, in now, biology 101.
2020.
How do you know
a 65 years old woman, has she ever bleed once a month?
By what?
Yes, they do.
If a woman, 9 years old, you said by development of body. If 9 years old woman
today bleed once a month.
You said a woman by development of body.
I have lots of arguments like this one about the time that had before and now. But I can't compare. I don't compare what it was there, then and now.
Do you think Surah 65 is not for 21st century?
I think the
Surah 65,
the deeds that have been done at that time, you cannot bring them to 2020.
So Muhammad is not perfect example.
He is perfect example.
That's what your perfect example did.
You can't compare these things.
Why? That's what your perfect example did, and he put that verse in the Quran, Surah 65, verse 4.
No, that's what
brother, if you go to all of the tafsirs, you get them here. So all of the tafsir are here. Yeah. It is talking about you are divorcing a child who is yet to have her period. For you to divorce them, you need to marry with them and have sex with them. You are having sex with the children who are yet to have their period. If you are saying it was just for that time, then we are simply saying Quran is not relevant to us today. Muhammad is not the best example.
I understood your point, but I have a different view on that.
What are you doing about Surah 65 verse 4? Sorry, Surah 4 verse 65.
But it doesn't say that.
Surah 4 verse 65.
I just read it.
I'm just mentioning Surah 4 verse 65,
which talks about.
No, you have that Surah 65 verse 4.
Okay.
So Surah 4 verse 65, Muhammad must be the judge in all things, and you have to submit him in fully. So your prophet did that. Your prophet put that in the Quran, Surah 65 verse 4. Now, it is in the Quran. Therefore, it is not only for 7th century. Quran, are we trying also say that Quran is only for 7th century? Is the Quran only for 7th century?
No, it's not.
So,
it's not.
If Quran is not only for 7th century, how are you dealing with Surah 65 verse 4?
That's the common sense.
So,
Quran goes against common sense.
It's not.
Quran doesn't go against common sense. But as a man who did not receive the revelation from Allah, you wouldn't have a sex with a child who yet to have her period, and you wouldn't divorce a child who is yet to have her period.
What does mean child? Tell her, what is child? Tell her, ask her this one, what is child? Tell us what is child.
Tell me what Gabriel told you. Tell me what Gabriel told you. What is the question comes from Gabriel?
What is child?
Because they think this Muslim man doesn't have a brain to think. That's what happened when you... What kind of help is it?
I'm not enough knowledgeable about Islam.
Sir, I am not asking. I am not asking you. Give me the Islam.
If you didn't have enough knowledge, why did you come here?
This is basic knowledge.
I'm still learning.
This is basic knowledge.
I'm still learning.
Even that tattoo.
It doesn't mean that I started learning from the first day when I got converted.
Receive the tattoo and receive the tattoo.
It was before. I did my tawbah. It was before. Before 2014. Yeah. I had them. Not after I converted.
Wrap up.
He did it before his conversion. Is your family Christian?
Yes, they are. But they don't practice. They don't practice.
No, hold on. I know they don't practice. But are they sort of considered Christian? I know they don't practice. Are they Christian?
Yeah, because we were born in a Christian country.
So, here's my basic problem.
You cannot ally to them.
This gentleman has been Muslim for 6 years.
Don't read them, my friend. Don't read.
And because Islam is logical and rational, there is no answer. There is no basic answer to my question on the Tawhid. There is no proper answer to the black stone.
Who is not knowledgeable about Islam and argue with
them. Well
done.
Muslims today disagree. You don't need to be Einstein. Don't play victim game.
I came here to listen to your point against Islam, not to argue with you. This is the first thing.
Okay, now you heard my objection.
Now you're saying, look at this convert. He doesn't know what he's talking about.
I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is, you've been Muslim for 6 years.
She was just saying that in the camera.
You've been Muslim for six years. You were not even able to answer basic Islam 101. 101 101 on Tawhid. There is no basic answer to the black stone. There is no even basic answer what Muhammad did to Aisha, but what we are getting is that was for that time. Muhammad is for that time, not for 21st century. Surah 65 verse 4. Surah 65 verse 4.
In the Bible.
Doesn't make sense to the Muslims. Muslims wouldn't practice it, but it is still in the Quran. Give up Islam as now you can. Give it up now you can before Islam takes over speaker's corner.